As a trader, sometimes you cannot use the standard pitchfork to describe market fluctuations properly. Suppose the market forms a spike or V-shaped bottom pattern during its movement. In such situations, there is only one significant fractal you can rely on to draw your pitchfork. Inside median lines are among the tools that can be used in those situations, where you cannot find a meaningful relationship between major fractals. To draw the median line of this particular pitchfork, instead of connecting pivot A to the middle point of B and C, try to draw a trend line joining pivot C, which is in fact the reversal point of the new emerging trend, to the middle of the swing formed by A and B. You can use Fibonacci retracement from your toolbar to find this point precisely. Then, with the help of this line, the upper and lower parallel lines of the pitchfork can be drawn from pivots A and B, respectively. Some resources call this reverse pitchfork, because by choosing point C as the anchor, your pitchfork is drawn to the left of your chart but can be projected into the future to predict forthcoming market movements. After drawing the inside median lines, the price should be able to touch the upper or lower parallel lines or show a proper reaction to the median line. In any case, it is better to carefully monitor the price response to the different lines of the pitchfork before deciding to count on it in your analysis. In this example, you can see that the share price has been in an uptrend for a long time without a significant correction, but after nearly 4 years, a deep correction can't be considered unreasonable. But due to the long-term bullish cycle in this asset, many traders are waiting to catch the next bullish trend. So, it seems necessary to draw a pitchfork to achieve this goal. But when we draw a classic pitchfork using these three fractals, we realize that the price did not react appropriately to it and went out of its boundaries. But maybe a different kind of pitchfork would help us with that problem. Therefore, by using the fractals A, B, and C, we draw a reverse pitchfork in the same way as explained in the previous example and carefully examine the price reaction to it. As you can see, the price has failed to cross the median line of this pitchfork 3 times and then, by forming a higher low, moved away from the pitchfork and started a new uptrend. Sometimes the price breaks through one of the pitchfork's upper or lower parallel lines, but suddenly returns inside the pitchfork's borders after making an up or down fractal. When this happens, using that fractal, you can draw a line parallel to the main lines of the pitchfork. We call it a sliding parallel line because its location can be adjusted according to the behavior of the price. These lines can act as new support and resistance areas. Therefore, using them allows you to design high probability trading setups or select the accurate stop loss or take profit levels. After drawing the first sliding parallel line, the rest of the sliding lines can be drawn by keeping the same distance from different pitchfork lines. One way to use sliding parallel lines is to look for buy or sell opportunities when the price hits the following sliding line after the first line proves its validity. In fact, the pitchfork boundaries are reconsidered based on these new lines. In this example, you can see that after returning inside the pitchfork's boundaries, the price has moved towards the second sliding line. After showing a suitable reaction, it moved away from it and started another movement towards the third sliding line. Then, after 2 failed attempts to cross this line, it has found resistance and formed a solid reversal candlestick pattern. So you could go short after detecting this bearish engulfing candle and place your stop loss above this up fractal. As we have already mentioned, in addition to acting as support and resistance areas, the sliding parallel lines can also be used to specify the take profit levels. Here, the first sliding line seems to be an excellent spot to place our take profit level, and as you can see, the price has reached it. In this example, you can see that the price bounces back after reaching the median line and then moves towards the upper parallel line of the pitchfork. But after crossing it a little and forming an up fractal, it returns inside the pitchfork's borders without hitting the first warning line. Therefore, as mentioned in the previous example, we can draw the first and second sliding parallel lines. Subsequently, when the price reaches the second sliding line, it reacts to it by forming a solid reversal candlestick pattern and issues a buy signal. Another way that we can use the sliding parallel line is when the price breaks it. In such cases, you can enter the market in the direction of price movement. Such breakouts can lead to extended price moves in the same direction, especially when the price fluctuates within the range formed by the sliding lines and the upper or lower parallel lines of the pitchfork, or even the warning lines, and finally breaks the sliding parallel lines, like what happened here. The price then started a solid uptrend that lasted many months. This chart shows that the price has been fluctuating inside a standard pitchfork. Then, it moves to the lower parallel line without reaching the median line and crosses it a little, but with the formation of a down fractal, it returns to the pitchfork's boundaries. We draw a sliding line from this fractal according to the slope of the median line and then draw the next sliding line by maintaining the same distance. Subsequently, after testing the first sliding line a few times, the price manages to cross it a little, but this does not mean that the sliding line has been broken because none of the conditions of a valid breakout has been met. Then the price returns inside the pitchfork and starts its upward movement towards the median line. In this situation, you can draw another sliding line from the pivot marked on the chart, and then draw its image by keeping the same distance from the median line. This way, you get a sliding zone that can more accurately describe future price reactions in that area. After reaching the specified spot on the chart, the price reacts to it and moves away from there by forming a reversal pattern, which can be the first significant sign of trend reversal. In the following, the price crosses the first sliding zone by forming a price gap, in which a final warning is issued for the trend reversal. But traders who are more patient and looking for a trading opportunity with a better risk-reward ratio, can wait and go short when the price rebounds and touches the first sliding zone once again. In the following, the price reached the specified sliding zone on the chart and then continued its previous uptrend by forming a reversal pattern. I hope you liked the video. If you found the information in this video valuable, please share it with your friends and help us with YouTube's algorithm. Thanks for watching.